Today we're going to be looking at an actual tensile experiment, a tensile test, and we'll be looking at the development of the stress strain curve while the tensile test is actually in progress. And this experiment is going to be on a piece of mild steel that has been heat treated. And so what you'll see is you'll see a coating on the outside of the steel, which is basically an oxide carbide coating. So that's a brittle coating. And then on the inside is the steel specimen, which is obviously a ductile material. And so one of the interesting things that you'll observe as the test goes on is that as the tensile specimen is stretched out and elongated, the brittle material on the surface of it will fracture, and you'll see those cracks developing as the specimen gets longer, while the inside material deforms plastically. The other interesting thing about steel is that, unlike many other materials like aluminum or copper or brass, when it first yields, there's an upper and lower yield point. And the reasons for that are really beyond the scope of elementary strength of materials. It's because the objects that cause plastic deformation in a metal are crystal defects called dislocations. And at the beginning of the deformation of steel, those dislocations are trapped at internal particles. The carbon in the steel traps those dislocations, and so it takes a while for all the dislocations in the material to become free of those trapped locations. So the bottom line is that what that means is that after the initial steep elastic curve, there's a jiggly portion of the stress strain curve while those dislocations are being freed, and then we start seeing the traditional strain hardening portion of the curve. And here we observe the beginning of the test. You see the coating is perfectly intact when the test begins, and you see the steep rise in the stress. This is the elastic portion, and already the material has begun to deform plastically. You'll notice the elastic portion was a linear, very steep rise in the stress with strain. And now we've reached that upper yield point, and now we've reached the lower yield point. You can see the ceramic coating on the outside of the specimen fracturing as the specimen elongates. You see little flakes of the black stuff coming off the specimen. And now the entire specimen is deforming plastically, and you see a return to the smooth rise of the stress-strain curve that indicates normal strain hardening behavior. As the specimen gets longer and longer, the engineering stress, which is what we're observing on the y-axis, will continue to rise. That basically indicates the material is getting harder and stronger during the plastic deformation. You'll notice the length of the specimen is getting longer. At the beginning of the specimen, the top of the specimen, at the beginning of the test, the top of the specimen was significantly further down than it is now. And when we get to the ultimate tensile strength, which is probably in about 20 or 30 seconds or so, where the stress reaches its maximum, you'll see that the top portion of the specimen will be almost out of the frame of the video. The strain hardening actually continues all the way through the end of the test. What happens when we reach the ultimate tensile strength, which is the maximum of the engineering stress on the tensile curve, is that you start developing a local neck, and about 40% up from the bottom of the specimen, you'll begin to see the neck forming right when the stress reaches its maximum. So right about now, about 40% up from the bottom of the specimen, you'll start observing a mild neck forming, and then the neck becomes more and more severe until it eventually fractures the specimen. And at that point, the specimen breaks, and you'll see all remaining residue of the black coating being shaken off the specimen. So we've reached ultimate tensile strength. Fracture is imminent. And there it goes.